Good morning, and welcome to your daily Farm and Home Show, brought to you by the University of Kentucky Cooperative Extension Service. And now, here's your host.
Good morning, and welcome to your Farm and Home Show. My name is Joanna Coles, and this morning we're visiting with Jana Sublett. She's the Executive Director of CASA. Good morning, yes. Jana.
Good morning. Thanks for having us.
I'm glad you're here today, because I think your organization does such important work, but some people might not be familiar with it. So tell us a little bit about CASA.
I do think that because of the nature of what we do, it is very confidential. So a lot of times people don't really dive into the mission and that sort of thing. So what I usually tell people is we're an organization where we recruit and train concerned citizen volunteers to advocate for abused and neglected children in the family court and foster care system. And you know, a lot of times you want to dive a little bit more into that. What does that mean? Advocacy and those kinds of things. And you know, we have right at 70 volunteers right now. We were able to serve 196 kids at the end of last year. And when I say serve again, that is advocating, looking out for the best interests of these children that we're working with. Again, those kids are referred to us from the family court systems in the six counties that we represent. And so we do actually receive referrals from Barron, Butler, Edmondson, Hart, Metcalf, and Warren County. So it's a pretty
large reach.
Yeah, pretty large reach. These individuals, you know, are, once they're assigned, they go through a training process, and we'll talk a little bit about training and what our next training is and how to get involved. But they go through a pretty thorough training process. They go through 30 hours of training, and then they're assigned to either a child or a sibling group. And these kids are children of dependency, neglect, or abuse. And they just kind of start kind of researching the case, what's happened up until that point. And then they're also building rapport with the partners in the case, the social workers, the doctors, psychiatrists, therapists, folks like that. And then, of course, also building rapport with the children. Mm-hmm. Because we want to make sure that as a representative of that child, that we're able to relay their voice in the court system.
Jana, that all sounds like such a great mission, but the first thing that comes to my mind is, am I qualified? Am I qualified to do that? Is there background that a volunteer would have to have?
So really what we're looking for is anyone over the age of 21, and you do have to pass a number of background checks, of course, a federal, a state, an abuse, neglect background check. So you gotta be able to do all of that. But really, to be honest with you, you know, a lot of times people think, oh, well, I have to either be a lawyer because it's a court thing, or I have to be a social worker. But really, you know, I know when the judge is looking at these volunteers out in the courtroom, they like that these folks are stay-at-home moms, retirees, folks that work in light industrial, engineers, realtors, anything that you can think of. I mean, because they bring a different perspective to the case and the child and their recommendations that they're, again, bringing back to the court, bringing back to the judge, and the judge is reading those. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I think that any type of background that you have is going to be beneficial to our program. So,
absolutely. Yeah. And I know that you guys are taking those, but do you have enough? You mentioned how many children you served. Are there more children need?
Yeah. And you know, we just to get a little bit into numbers. So again, we have right at 70. We were able to serve 196, which sounds like a great number, and it is. You know, every year we increase the number, or we have been able to in the last several years, increase the number of children that we're advocating for. However, if you're looking at numbers, there are right around, I think last time I checked, there were 357 children in foster care alone in Warren County, and that was just in Warren County. Uh-huh. So if you think about that in relation to, that's the size of Oakland Elementary School. That's how many kids are in foster care just in Bowling Green, just in Warren County. If you're looking at the six county region as to what we could do if we had the number of people that we need to be advocates, you're looking at 1,500 kids that have had dependency, neglect, abuse cases substantiated in our region in the last year.
And I know that this takes time, it takes volunteers, it takes funding for to be able to service even the kids that you do. Right. And I know next month is a special awareness month.
Yeah. So next month is Child Abuse Prevention Month, or Child Abuse Awareness Month, sorry. It used to be called Child Abuse Prevention Month. And so it's a great time for us to bring awareness and talk about our mission a lot more. So we're really excited to be able to come kind of at the end of March, talk about what some of the things that we've got going on for next
month. So how do they find out? You have a Facebook page, a website?
We have a very social, very active Facebook page, Twitter, We have a website, we have a Instagram, all of those things. So yeah, Casa of South Central Kentucky. You do want to make sure that you look for us.
All right, yeah. So it's Casa, C-A-S-A, right?
Yes, Casa, C-A-S-A.
Of South Central Kentucky. So yeah. Go like, follow, find out more information. But we appreciate you watching and hope you have a great day. Farm and Home Show. My name is Joanna Coles, and this morning we're visiting with Jana Sublett. She's the executive director of CASA here in South Central Kentucky. Good morning, Jana.
Good morning. Thanks for having us.
Well, I'm glad you're here today because it takes a lot of volunteers to kind of carry out your mission at CASA.
Yes.
And so tell us a little bit about how the volunteers work into the system.
Okay. So again, you know, CASA, we recruit and train citizen volunteers to advocate for abused and neglected children in the family court and foster care system. So kind of how that trickles out is our referral source are the family court judges here in the region. And again, we get referrals from Barron, Butler, Edmondson, Hart, Metcalf, and Warren counties. But, you know, even if you live outside of those counties, there are children, there are CASA kids living in your county. Yeah, so if you have any interest in us, don't let that deter you. We actually just swore in a couple of ladies. One was from Allen County and one was from Logan County recently that, you know, still, you know, really love our mission, but know that they won't get kids that's home counties are there, but they will have children likely in their county that are foster children from other counties, because
gotcha.
If you know anything about the foster care system, kids don't always land in their home counties. It's based on where they can place them, where the social services, DCBS, can place them. So, but yeah, so, you know, again, we have right at 70 volunteers. We served 196 kids in 2018, but there was a pretty big gap where there was over 1,000 kids that could have used our services if we had the folks and the volunteers and the advocates in place. So so what we're looking for, you know, again, don't have to have any kind of specific background. You have to be able to pass a multiple background checks, and then the process would then lead into, we do some interviewing on the front end, and then we kind of progress into the training, which is 30 hours. It is a 30-hour training, and I know that sounds like a lot to folks, but we wanna make sure, you know, as ambassadors of our program, that these folks are ready and willing and able to take and work with the kids that, you know, are referred to us. So the training dives into a lot of different things. Of course, we talk about family law. That's, again, our referral source working with the judges. We talk about trauma and resilience in children, ACEs, if anybody's aware of what that is, adverse childhood experiences. We talk a lot about that. We talk about communication and how to communicate with the different partners in the case, and of course, working with the kids, you know. We talk about culture and different, and how that plays into the work that we do. We talk about domestic violence. We talk about drug abuse, because again, those are a lot of the times the reason that children end up in foster care is because of things going on in the home. So, after the training, we do some after interviewing, and then we do a swearing in with the judges, depending on what judge they're going to be working with. And, then we match those folks with kind of, you know, the best we can with the cases and we have a waiting list right now. I think there's over 30 kids right now just on our waiting list that, you know, we're waiting for folks to get sworn in. We actually did a swearing in earlier this week, so we'll be placing those 8 individuals with the kids on our waiting list. So we're very excited about, you know, getting them going.
But these trainings, because it is a pretty intense training,
yeah,
they only happen certain times of the year.
Right,
so if
yeah.
people want to get involved.
Yeah, so right now we have 2 coming up. One is in Warren County, and that's a weekday daytime training. It starts June 17th. So check our website. We've got, check our Facebook page. I know that we have the flyer on there. And then we also will be doing a training for the first time this year. We're very excited to be doing a training in Barron County in Glasgow at the TJ Sampson Community Center. So we're very excited to really, you know, we've been in Barron County, we've been serving Barron County kids for a number of years, but we finally have enough momentum that we're gonna be able to do a full training there.
That's awesome. So, and those surrounding counties can come to one
course,
of those
yeah,
trainings.
Of course, yeah, for sure, yeah. And again, these are both weekday daytime trainings. And then in the fall, we'll do weekday evening trainings.
Okay. So if that fits your schedule,
that fits your schedule. And then the winter time we do Saturdays, full Saturday. Okay. So it's like basically no matter what you do for a living, you should be able to fit in one of the sessions that we have, because they're all different times of the year and different times of the day and different times of the week.
Now, Jane, I'm not very familiar with family court and how cases work. How much is the time commitment?
So, you know, really, a lot of times I think there is a misconception that there, you know, you have to put in a ton of time. Our one bare, like, you absolutely have to see the child once a month. And so we want to make sure that, you know, you're building that rapport and that you're getting that feedback from them so that you can take this information and get recommendations from the judge.
All right. Well, Jana, certainly appreciate all the information. And if you're interested, make sure to go find them on Facebook. We appreciate you watching and hope you have a great day.
If you have questions about today's topic, please call the Warren County Extension Office at the number on your screen. Thanks for watching and have a great day.